Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain the concept of arrays and pointers in C programming language. So pointer is a special type of variable which can hold the address of any variable. Now coming to an array, it's a collection of homogeneous data type. That is, it is grouping of all the similar data under a single name. So now we'll see what the relation between the pointers and array. So when we take an array, the address of each and every element in array is represented by using an ampersand array of the index position. So simply we can give array of 0 also, that is also access the address of that particular array, because arrays can used implicitly the pointers concept. The base address of array can be held by a pointer. So because of that, when we are using for loop, when I increments, the index value is automatically get increments and it takes the next position of an array. So here is a program. So we'll show you the concept of arrays and pointers in C programming language. So here we are finding the average of given array elements. So by using the pointers and arrays concept. So here it is my header file. So stdio.h, and after that this is my function declaration. So here my function name is average, because I want to find the average of a given array elements, and it will return an integer value to my main function. And after that it will take two things as an argument. One is an array pointer and the second one is the size of an array. So this is my main function. So in that main function I am declaring one variable, that is the array variable, so which can hold maximum of 20 elements of type integers. And here is my pointer, is also of type integer, and this is the array pointer because it can hold the address of an array. So always the pointer and the variable must be the same data type. So here n I am taken for reading the size of an array. And I'm using in my for loop. So now I'm prompting the user for entering the size of an array, and it will read by a scanf statement simply percentile d ampersand n. Why I am taking the array size means my array maximum size is 20. Every time when I'm executing this program, I may or may not be interested to take 20 values to examine. So what simply I'm doing is I can ask the user what is his own interest. So then depends on that, I will read the array values. So now it is my for loop, i0, I less than n, i++, because always array index starts from 0. And it always take values less than n, because the last index of my array is n minus 1. And then here I am prompting the user to enter a of percentile d position element. So now this percentile d will get from index value. So in that it will ask you like enter a of 0 position element. And after that when I increments, it will ask you enter a of 1 position element, and so on. It will execute it for n iterations. So by simply a scanf statement, I am using percentile d and send a of I. Right, so here, and then this is a pointer and array concept, right? Like we have to initialize your array to a pointer variable. So here your array and pointer both are of type integers. So now these both will be of a same data type. So APTR is nothing but your array pointer, which can hold the address of array variable. So previously, when we discussed about a pointer's concept, simply variable name before we are preceding an ampersand symbol. For arrays, it is not needed, because I already said pointer can hold implicitly the address of a array variable. So now simply you can give your array name, that is enough for assigning to a array pointer. And after that, simply I'm calling my function average, and here I'm passing my pointer. And then the size of my array. So this is my function definition. So in that function definition, so I can follow the same prototype which I am declaring at my declaration part, see here, int average, int star array, comma, int n. So you can use the same at the definition time also, because the prototype, it must be similar. And here I have two variables. One is I, which I am using in my for loop for computing the sum. And after that, I'll take the average of that particular array elements. So then I'm using my variable sum. Initially I'm taken it as 0 because I want to take the first position of an array element to add something with that. So for that I'm taken my variable sum and initialized it 0. So I'm declaring one more variable average because after I'm finding the sum of array elements, I need to divide by n to get the average of that many numbers. So sometimes it will return you a floating point. Because of that reason, I'll take my average variable is of type float. And after that, in for loop, simply I'm run my for loop for n iterations to take n value from the user. So it initially starts with 0 index, i0 and I less than n, i++. So now I simply add sum equals to sum plus. So now array of 1 or array of I and array plus I both are similar. So now it will take the array and you can give a position. It simply says that, okay, it will take array of 1 position or array of 0 position, like that. So array is a pointer variable, right? So now you can get the value in that position. You have to use a dereference operator. That's why reason here we are taken asterisk symbol. So now it will add all the elements of an array. And after finding the sum of all my array elements, simply I can perform an average operation. See here, I'm doing typecasting because my sum is of type integer. So now I'm trying to divide an integer by float. So it leads me something difficult. So that's why I'm casting my integer to floating point. Means simply I'm converting integer to float before I'm performing the average operation. So here float of m divide by n. So whatever the n value is provided by the user, and again the sum will be divided by that value. And after that I'm trying to print my average is percentile f, and I get that value from avg. And now I'm returning my avg. Okay. So because why I'm here and return avg, because my average is of type integer. Okay. So now I'll compile and execute this program. So now it will ask me the size of an array. So my array size is actually 20, but I'm not interested to take 20 values, so that I'm given my array as 10. So now it will ask me A of 0 position element, I'll give as 45, and A of 1 position, I'll give as 23, and next I'll give as 41, and after that 56, 78, 96, 12, 78, then 23, 45. So it will ask me up to A of 9 because I want to take 10 elements. So my first index is 0. From 0 to 9, I can access 10 elements. So now see, it will find the average of all these numbers. See, simply it can add and it will display me like 49.7001 something. So if I want to format this average value to display after decimal two places, simply I can give here. At the time of displaying, here I can give 0.2. So I need, after my decimal places, I need only 2 digits. So I can execute the same program again. So now I'll take my array size is small. So it is 5. So it will ask me for A of 4 positions up to. So I'll give first element as 45 and the next element as 56 and next element as 78 and next element as 25 and next element as 99. So now it will show me average. See, you can observe that after decimal places I can have only 2 digits. So thank you.